Bowser being good is practically a, what's the word? It's not something that, like, should happen in Smash. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't mind.
It's kind of a bizarre thing.
I actually think that heavies are in a decent place in Smash 4, where, like,
they're
solid mid-tiers.
Yeah.
Obviously...
As the meta goes for Smash 4, you're going to see only the top tiers be relevant.
Sure. I can imagine. That's
we don't have the time to let it go to that.
Yeah.
There's also no reason to let it go to that.
Like,
we've got the new one coming.
Yeah, we can definitely see how top tiers are overpowering a lot of other characters
as you get better.
Get better at the game.
As you get better at pressing your buttons.
Anyways.
But we got Lucina Sheik, yeah.
Yeah, makes sense. In the set I saw earlier, I haven't actually seen... I saw Vinnie play against... who was it?
Suarez, right? I think.
Suarez, yeah. I didn't know Suarez had a Greninja, but...
He does for Bayo, yeah.
Okay. Makes sense.
No, I don't blame him.
Yeah. Right, Mr. E, I just saw play shortly ago, and he was just so oppressive when his opponent was off stage.
Both of these guys are wild.
Oh, absolutely.
And they're fun to play against, too.
I believe it. I actually haven't played against either. But
I feel like I'm at my best when I'm playing them, because they just push you.
Oh, yeah. Because
plus, the good thing about them, as their training partners, once you're good, you push your opponent to be better.
Yeah, exactly.
So if you both... that's not gonna. Yeah, okay. Sheik doesn't SD.
I always forget how far that up B goes sometimes.
Yeah.
Play a little too much melee.
Yeah.
I like these options from Mr. E, just making it miserable to cover the ledge. But obviously, Vinny not letting Mr. E land.
I thought he was a little late on that up smash, too, but
yeah,
he got it.
Yeah, good stuff. Oh, yeah, shields it, gets more damage. Wow. He is doing a lot of work right now.
And when you play people a lot, I don't know if these guys can attest to this. I'm sure they can. It almost feels like your sets get scripted.
Yeah, I can
like you know
what the other person's gonna do well enough.
Yeah, there's certain interactions that are just normal when you get to that level.
Wow.
Like, their up smash, that was really good. That was a good pickup.
Very well done. That was
anyway,
really fast game.
Yeah, that's how. When you play your training partner, it goes like.
That's fair.
Like, I've played mostly with a few people, because everyone ends up having a few people that fail all the time. And it feels like, you know, it's the same stuff and the same stuff. And you got to reach out to everyone else and play them so you get new stuff.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because you'll see these guys grinding on Wi-Fi. You'll see them go into majors and everything. And that's really the first step in getting better, is to. Expand your circle.
Yeah, absolutely. I've been having that problem where I've just been playing at my college locals. And it's, you know, it's good. There's decent people there, but everyone there is just they're learning player matchups, but not character matchups.
Yeah.
They're not learning how to play against people they haven't played against before.
And you'll see that. I know I'm not talking about the game anymore, but that's why you'll see, you know, regions like, oh, they go to majors and everyone says they're so good and they have these cool plays on their weeklies. Their Twitch clips go viral, and then they lose to a different character they're used to, or they lose to just someone you're like, oh, I thought they would beat them for sure. It's just because they don't have the
adaptation.
But, so that's why clicks and Smash don't really turn out that well.
Wow, we're already in winter semis. Actually, didn't realize.
This is a... classic winter semis.
Yeah,
when the buzz is here, at least.
This game is a lot closer than the last one. I think it's
partially
a momentum thing.
Eric's taking his time. He's not. Mystery's taking his time. He's not landing as recklessly. Maybe not.
I don't hate the option, but Vinny was just very ready for it.
It can catch a lot of people off guard, because once you get to like high level, is like mid level. Like, you're following the rules, quote-unquote.
Yeah.
You're playing the game as everyone's expecting it to. And then you'll see that in the mid-level player. Or like, oh, he did this conversion. Oh, that was good, and that's good. And then when you get to high and top-level players, you see them start throwing in the things that they shouldn't do as well as the stuff they should do.
Yes, mix-ups.
But,
they expect the same traditional stuff, so...
Yeah, they throw in... You can't just have one or the other.
Right.
But... once you throw in the random stuff, there's that saying, the best swordsman in the world only has to fear the worst swordsman.
Yeah.
It's kind of like that. Sometimes you just got to go with your gut.
Oh, that almost killed.
Yeah, Sheik's at 150.
Vinny's drift has been incredible this set. I think that's really what's getting him a lot of this advantage, is he just, like, you know, the difference is Vinny's getting these strong combos, and Mr. B's, like, his big thing is edge guarding a lot of the time. You know?
Yeah.
I've seen him kill so many.
And Sheik's hard to edge guard.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
He's not mixing up his timings on Sheik's usual options enough to catch them.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, as a sword character, you have to...
It's all about timing.
Yeah, you'll beat that move, but you have to press it at the right time.
Yeah. Getting off of ledge as a swordie is not an easy life either, just because, you know, one of the biggest advantages you have is being able to sort of be a portable wall, you know, cover so much
space. Oh, and then another near up smash, yeah.
Vinny's conversions in the up smash have been so clean. It's very convincing, yeah.
Swords are definitely...